Hello friends, most welcome to English Advantage online classes. Friends, in this video I am going to discuss latest pattern, best spotting error questions for all banking and SSC exams. And these are the typical banking and SSC spotting error questions. And these kind of questions were recently asked in SBI PO and SBI CAP exams. So we will discuss these spotting errors in good detail. But before I proceed further, I would like to intimate you that I have started this particular website called EnglishIQ.in. Here you can get free English section study material in the form of PDFs, in the form of ebooks, and in the form of crash courses, video courses. Okay. So let us get started with this video class. This is the first question, and you have to find out in which part there is grammatical error. Now let us read this entire sentence. No two country. Now if you notice these two words, you will find that this word two should follow a plural noun. Two books, two pens, two friends. In the same way, it should be written as two countries. Okay. So in this part, there is error. So error lies in part A. Okay, so this is the right way of solving spotting error questions. The moment you spot the error, you should tick the error and you should tick mark your answer and you should move forward. Now let us see the question number two. India has witnessed the rise of Hindu right as not just a political but also a cultural force like never before. Now in this sentence, let us read this sentence from beginning till end. India has witnessed, this witness is correct because this is followed by has, so this witness is correct. The rise of what? The rise of Hindu right. But this Hindu right is a particularized noun. We are not talking about any right but the Hindu right. So this Hindu right should be preceded by the definite article the. Okay. So here the error is in part B. I hope you understand this. India has witnessed the rise of the Hindu right. It's a very good question. Okay, now let us see the next question. The unique geography of Kerala with its steep climb down from 900 meter high elevation of the Western Ghats to the coast of Malabar has resulted in a land with a vast riverine network. Riverine network means related with rivers and full of rivers, you can say. So let me go through this sentence once again. The unique geography of Kerala, till here this is correct, with its steep climb down from 900 meter high elevation of the Western Ghat. Western Ghats is preceded by the, which is correct. And the coast of Malabar is preceded by the, which is also correct. Resulted is always followed by a proposition in. Land is preceded by A, which is correct, with a vast riverine network. I think the sentence is correct and here your answer is no error. Okay. Let us see the next question. After the floods in Kerala in 2018, the Chief Minister's team. Chief Minister's team, this team belong to Chief Minister, so that is why we are using this apostrophe S, which is correct. Now the Chief Minister visited in past, so that is why we are using this verb visited correctly. Okay, visited the Netherlands. We always say the Netherlands. Netherlands is preceded by the, and this Netherlands country is always written in plural. So this is also correct. To learn how cities with high levels of a water footprint are dealing in climate changes issues. They are not dealing in, but they are dealing with climate change issues. If you are dealing in something, you are doing a kind of business with that particular entity. For example, you can say I am dealing in sugar. It means I do the business of sugar. But you, when you deal with something, you deal with people or you deal with issues. So here we are talking about dealing with issues. So that is why dealing in is incorrect and it should be replaced by dealing with. Okay. So here your answer is D because error lies in part D. I hope you understand this question. Now let us see the next question. Post disaster management of land and geography needs. Needs is used for this management. Okay, this needs is connected with this subject management, which is singular. So needs is okay here. Needs is correct here. Imagination, post-disaster management of land and geography needs imagination action. What is imagination actions? Now action being noun here, it should be preceded by adjective, not noun. Okay, so what kind of actions we are talking about? We are talking about imaginative actions, not imagination action. If you write imagination action, this is noun and this is also noun. But here the noun should be followed by adjective. So this should be written as imaginative. So here this is a word related mistake, word related error. And error lies in part B. So here your answer is B. I hope you understand this question. Now let us see the question number 6. Over the past few days, over the past few days means during the past few days, because over means during. Okay, there has been expressions of concern. Now look at this verb, there has been. This has been is connected with what? This has been is connected with expressions, which is plural. Okay, so that is why this has been should be replaced by have been. There have been expressions. Okay, if you were to use expression, then you would use has been. But since the sentence is expressions, so it should be replaced by have been. So here your answer is A. Okay. If you spot the error in part A, you do not need to read the remaining sentence, because it will be a time wastage. But if you do not understand the sentence and sentence is creating confusion in your mind, you can read the complete sentence. Now let us see the question number 7. The court has also taken note of the delay in trials. The court is correctly preceded by the, because here you are talking about a particular court. Has is followed by taken, which is correct. Taken note of the delay in what? Delay in trials. In turn, directing the central government to set up special courts within 60 days of the order in each district. Each district have more than 100 pending cases. Now look at this word have. We are talking about the districts which are having 100 pending cases. We are talking about the district which are having 100 pending cases. So here we are kind of modifying this district. And these kind of nouns are modified by present participle. Okay, so here you should say each district having more than 100 pending cases. Each district having more than means that hatch or that have. Okay, so each district having more than 100 pending cases under the act. So here your answer is D. Okay, this is a very good question, and I hope you understand this this explanation. This is a very good question. Now, question number 8, let us see the question number 8. And these kind of questions you can expect in forthcoming IBPS PO and IBPS clerk exams, because these are the typical spotting error questions. Now let us see here, diplomats here have pointed out, diplomats is plural, so have is correct, and pointed out is also correct. Diplomats have pointed out that, they have pointed out what? They have pointed out that China's push to bring back Kashmir to the UNSC, that is United Nations Security Council, this show is connected to China's push, and China's push is singular. So that is why you should write here shows, not show. So this C part is wrong here. So here your answer is C. The moment you spot the error, you should tick mark your answer, and you should move forward. You need not read the complete sentence. Okay, let us see the question number 9. Yesterday the Minister of Law and Justice issued is correct here, because we are talking about a past time, that is yesterday. Yesterday a notification, the title of the notification was notification titled the Constitution application to Jammu and Kashmir over 2019 overriding, again here we are using present participle. Okay, this notification is overriding. This notification is overriding or replacing the previous rule, overriding the order of 1954 and in effects. Actually, the correct phrase is in effect, not in effects. Okay, so this part is wrong. Scrapping means to remove something or end something. So here your answer is C. In place of in effects, you should write in effect. Okay. Let us see question number 10. In early June at a Niti Aayog meeting, Prime Minister Narendra Modi set a clear and bold economic target to grow India into a 5 trillion economy till 2024. Here we are talking about that this goal can be achieved even till 2024 or even before that at a particular time. So here you have to apply the meaning of not later than. Okay, because till indicate the last point. Till indicate the last point. I will teach you till 6 p.m. Okay, so my class will end at 6 p.m. It cannot end before 6 p.m. anytime before 6 p.m. So here actually the context say that this goal can be achieved till 2024 or even before that time. So here the correct word should be by 2024, not till 2024. Okay, so here the correct word is by. So here your answer is D. Now let us see the next question. History shows that no country has succeeded by accelerating its growth rate without raising the domestic saving rate to close to 40% of GDP. History shows is correct that no country has succeeded. Normally succeeded is followed by in, not by by. No country has succeeded in, it should be in, I think. History shows that no country has succeeded in accelerating its growth rate without raising the domestic saving rate to close to 40%. So here this by should be replaced by in. So here your answer is B. Okay. Let us see question number 12. This paper released in Harvard University postulated that the GDP growth between 2011-17 was significantly lower than the 7% shown in the official figures. The GDP growth between 2011-17 was significantly lower than the 7% shown in the official figure. If you look at it closely, you will notice that it is shown by the official figures, not shown in the official figures. Okay, this growth rate is indicated by official figures, not shown in the official figures. So here your correct answer is D. Okay, let us see the question number 13. At a time when the national capital is reeling under means it's highly pressurized. Okay, at a time when the national capital is reeling under increasing load of solid waste and is struggling with its scientific disposal, the civic bodies have initiated a fresh drive to tackle the issue head on. When you tackle something head on, you deal with it face to face, or deal with it directly, you can say. So at a time when the national capital is reeling under increasing load of solid waste and struggling, just see here the consistency of the sentence. Here you are talking about, here we are using present continuous tense, and here again we are using present continuous tense, which is correct. Okay, with its scientific disposal, the civic bodies have initiated is correct, the civic bodies is correct, a fresh drive is countable, so A is correct, to tackle the issue head on. The sentence is correct, and here your answer is E, that is no error. Okay. Let us see this question. Studies show that India's road transport emissions are smaller in global comparison, but increasing exponentially. Actually, this comparative degree is always followed by then. So here, then is missing. So that is why this word is inappropriate, and we should write small in global comparison. They are small in global comparison. Okay. So here your answer is B. Let us see question number 15. While the ASEAN outlook doesn't see, ASEAN is a group of countries, you must be knowing if you are preparing for GS also. While the ASEAN outlook doesn't see the Indo, ASEAN is a singular entity. That is why this doesn't is okay. See the Indo-Pacific as one continuous territorial space. It emphasizes development in connectivity. Sorry. Underlying the need for maritime cooperation, infrastructure connectivity, and broader economic cooperation. I think this sentence is correct. And here your answer is E. So that's it. I have compiled some 15 sentences in this video class, and I hope you like it. And I have recently started that the same video class will be recorded. I will be uploading the same video class in English language also. So the English language students and the students who cannot understand Hindi will be benefited highly by this initiative. And what is your opinion regarding the level of questions and regarding the level of explanation? Kindly let me know through the comment box. And if you're the first time visitor on this channel called English Advantage YouTube channel, please like it, share it with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe. And please visit this website also, englishiq.in. Here I have uploaded free content for English accent. So thank you very much for watching this video class, and I'll see you in my next video class. Thank you.